Greetings to all. Today I am going to deliver a talk on rural market and nature and characteristics of rural market. In my presentation, I will focus on the nature and characteristics of rural market, importance of rural market, various factors which have made rural markets viable, and 4 P's of marketing. Let me start with some general information about rural market. The rural population in India is around 70% of the total population. 62% of consumer expenditure in India comes from rural market. The rural market in India is not a separate entity, and it is highly influenced by the sociological and biological behavior operating in the behavior, and also the behavioral factors operating in the country. Rural markets are tomorrow's market. Rural market offers growth opportunities as the urban markets are increasingly competitive. Now, income level and standard of living is increasing rapidly in rural areas. The demand of branded products is also increasing. The rural market in India brings bigger revenues in the country, as the rural regions comprise of maximum consumers in the country. The rural market in Indian economy generates almost more than half of the country's income. According to the Census of India 2011, the rural market has been defined as a place where the population is not more than 5,000. The density of population is not more than 400 per square kilometer, and at least 75% of male working is engaged in agriculture. According to Reserve Bank of India, locations with population up to 10,000 will be considered as rural and 10,000 to 1 lakh as semi-urban. And according to the Planning Commission, places with population up to 15,000 are considered as rural. Now, I would like to highlight the nature and characteristics of rural market. The first characteristic of rural market is large and scattered market. The rural market is very large in size and mostly scattered. Here in India, the rural market consists of over 75 crore rural consumers from 6,38,365 villages spread throughout the country. Therefore, a large population gives an opportunity for marketing a variety of goods and services. Diverse socio-economic backwardness. Rural consumers have diverse socio-economic backwardness. This is different in different parts of the country. There exists tremendous variation in culture, lifestyle, taste, preferences, culture, and the like of the rural consumers. Income from agriculture. Agriculture and related activities continue to be the most occupation of majority of the rural population. Land is the major source of income for about 77% of population. It is evident that rural prosperity depends upon growth and development of agriculture. Standard of living. The consumer in the village area do have a low standard of living because of low literacy levels, low per capita income, social backwardness, low savings, economic backwardness, lack of exposure to media, etc. In general, the rural consumer spends less on non-food items. Infrastructural facilities. The infrastructure facilities like roads, warehouses, communication systems, and financial systems are inadequate in rural areas. Most of the rural markets are not connected by roads. And same is the problem with transporting the goods from urban market to rural areas. Hence, physical distribution is disadvantaged. Traditional outlook. The rural consumer values old customs and traditions. They do not prefer changes. In other words, the adaptability to change is lazy, and hence the problem of marketing of goods is much prevalent. Prevalence of false brands. Most of the markets are overwhelmed with local brands or false brands, which are quite cheaper and therefore affordable to the people. Seasonal demand. The rural markets are characterized by seasonal demand for products, especially costly products. This is due to the fact that agriculture is their main source of income and hence it is harvested. Then only they would be able to buy products. Media reach. The media reach in rural household is low, and therefore the marketer has to consider rural specific promotion media and methods to reach the villages. I would like to move on to the next part, the importance of rural market. The importance of rural market is increase in population and hence increase in demand. A marked increase in rural income due to agrarian prosperity. Standard of living is also increasing in rural areas. Large inflow of investment for rural development programs from government and other sources. Increased contact of rural people with their urban counterparts due to development of transport and wide communication network. Increase in literacy and educational level and resultant inclination to sophisticated lives by the rural folks. Inflow of foreign remittances and foreign made goods into rural areas. Change in the land tenure system causing a structural change in the ownership patterns and consequent changes in the buying behavior. Rural markets are strugglers in picking up new products. This will help the companies to phase their marketing efforts. This will also help to sell investors of products outdated in urban markets. I would like to raise briefly about various factors which have made rural markets viable are large population, rising prosperity, growth in consumption, lifestyle changes, lifestyle advantages, life cycle advantages, market growth rates higher than urban, rural marketing is not expensive, remoteness is no longer a problem. Finally, I would like to address 4 P's of marketing. Decisions about controlled marketing variables. 4 P's are product, price, promotion, and place, that is distribution. Several other P's are packaging, positioning, people, face, passions, publics, and even politics as well. I hope you understand the topic related to nature and characteristics of rural market, importance of rural market, various factors which have made rural markets viable, and 4 P's of marketing. Thank you.